Just before we sing, I heard a Christmas miracle story that made me tear up, made me get goosebumps. Mike, would you share it again with everyone?
Good afternoon, everyone. For those who may not know, my name is Mike Lindell. I spoke at St. Matthew's United Church this morning. 10 o'clock. It's on Weller Avenue, just off Montreal Street in Kingston. And there was a gentleman there, I suppose he was about 65 years old. I hadn't seen him before. Anyway, he was talking to John McCurd, his brother-in-law. John was saying, works a lot harder than you, Chris. No. And the gentleman said, can I speak to you alone? Certainly. So we went out to the bathroom and decided to. He held his head down and he said, when I was a little boy, he said I would put $7 off the collection plate. So now I came to make it right today. So that's very, very good of you. God has a way of redeeming us when we do things wrong. He said, yes. He said, I'll give you this envelope. That's the $7 times 100 for the church.
Let us stand and sing, O come all ye faithful, O come all ye faithful, found on page 60, and we're going to sing 1, 3, and 5, verses 1, 3, and 5. Let's make sure it's number 60. On the board up there it says 69, but I'm pretty sure it is 60.
Joyful and triumphant, O come.
going to be on our online congregation. It'll be up and running probably Boxing Day-ish, Chris? He's my tech guy. We're going to give him tomorrow off, but maybe by Boxing Day. But just keep an eye on our Facebook page and YouTube, and the services will be up. So welcome to those who are worshiping from home, and a very Merry Christmas to all of you. Thank you to our soloists tonight. We have a lot of readers. Thank you to all our readers who are participating in tonight's service. If you didn't get a little candle when you came in, there's a red basket at the back. Please help yourself. And if you don't mind returning them to the red basket at the end of the service, that would be great, because we have another service at 7 o'clock tonight. We have a service on New Year's Eve morning, on Sunday, next Sunday, New Year's Eve morning. The Sunday after that, January 7th, we're having Holy Communion at both churches. So the regular schedule is 9:15 in the morning here and 11:15 over at Inverary United Church. So you're welcome to all the services that are coming up and throughout 2023. You're also welcome to join us as we sing you're welcome to all the services of 2024. You're also welcome to come next Sunday to Inverary Church at 2 o'clock when we sing 2023 Goodbye with a fundraiser concert with Chris Murphy. At this time, I'm going to invite some or all of the Kunkey family, whatever you decide, to come on up. And as they come up, let's sing. You can remain seated as we sing, O Come, O Bright and Morning Star. The words are printed in your bulletin as we prepare for the lighting of the Christ candle, the Advent candles, and also our Christ candle.
Son given to us, authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Tonight we come seeking hope, peace, joy, and love. We pray these things in a child. God made flesh with a baby and a manger, a baby who is both the beginning and the end of our salvation. Who goes that even now are in Emmanuel, God with us.
We live as people in the in-between to celebrate the arrival of the light that shines in lost, broken places as we wait for the day when we will live in the fullness of God's kingdom.
We light these candles as signs of shocking hope, our just peace, our fierce joy, the love that transforms us, Jesus Christ, our wonderful light. May the light burning in our hearts guide us, comfort us, protect us, and tend us in all seasons and circumstances, reminding us that day and night, in the light and in the darkness, God is with us. Our salvation has come. Amen.
of hope, peace, joy, pink, love, and our Christ candle. If the kids could come up, I have a little story I'd like to share. Oh, microphone. Come on up. If you could come up and sit on the stairs, the kids are welcome to come up. And you need to be able to see me, so I would sit on the stair, or on the, actually, sit on the floor. The floor is better. That the floor is better, so you don't fall downstairs. I'm so glad we're in person this year. I can't even remember. So 2019 was the last time because we had COVID. And then last year, we were all set to meet in person and we had a blizzard. So Christmas Eve, we had our service was quickly, we pivoted to online. So we had Christmas in our living rooms last year, Christmas Eve service. I did this children's story online, so you might have seen it before, but I love it so much, it's my favorite, that we might be doing it every year. I think the grown-ups know which one this is. It is a candy Christmas story. Okay, so when I take a prop out of the bag, you need to shout what is on the prop, like what's on the package, okay? If you can read. If you can't read, then just listen, and then when you hear everybody else say it, then you can shout it out, okay? All right, so shout out what you see in my hand. A long, long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, as far as... Mars. Wrong story, sorry, let's try that again. A very long, long time ago, there was a cruel man named Herod, whose armies had overtaken large parts of the known world. He insisted that everyone who lived in those lands be counted. So, a man named Joseph and a woman named Mary set out for a place called Bethlehem. That's where Joseph had to be counted, because that was the place of his family's original home. Mary was going to have a baby. As they traveled along, it began to snow. And as the snow mixed with the dirt on the road, it began to
crunch
under their feet. They had to do something to pass the time. So Joseph would tell funny stories that made Mary
snickers.
They looked up into the
arrow.
I know that one's a bit of a stretch. And marveled at the beauty of God's world with all those brilliant stars in the sky. When they arrived in Bethlehem, they could find nowhere to stay, which was very sad because it was time for Mary to have her baby. A kind man took pity on them and said, "You can stay with my animals in the stable. It's not much, but it's all I have. Just watch out for one of the cows, the she's cranky."
I'm enjoying this more than you.
Said Joseph, "You're a later in the night, some shepherds ran the fields and they saw the most beautiful
stars
they had ever seen. It filled up the sky with a bright light. They heard angels singing and telling them not to be afraid, so they followed the
stars
to where the baby Jesus had been born. Now there were also some wise men traveling in the area. They went to see Herod and mentioned to him that they were searching for the anointed one, Jesus. And they had heard he would be born soon. Herod sent them out saying, "When you find him, be sure to let me know." The wise men did find Jesus, And they bowed before him to offer gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But they did not go and tell mean Herod where the child was. Instead, they went home by another road because they were
smarties.
And that's the end of a very sweet tale. And because all of you are smarties as well, Merry Christmas. And as we're having our smarties, Chris, can we sing Away in the Manger? Merry Christmas, everybody.
Justice and righteousness from now on forever.
The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
Peace. Peace that will never end, really? How can that be true? What prophet would say this and why? Isaiah? Would Isaiah say this to the captives of Israel? The ones suffering in exile, these prisoners of war? Oh, how their hearts yearned for peace. Long, long before the first Christmas, long before Mary and Joseph, long before the baby Jesus was born.
Issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David.
That's more like it. More like the real world. Back then and also today with the horrible wars happening in our Israel and Palestine. In our reading, we hear no peace here.
No peace, no peace.
No peace. Did not Caesar Augustus spin the story that he was the king of peace? Did he not have his praises sung in Rome? Yes, but how many wars did he fight? How many died? Israel was still under foreign control, under Rome now, not Babylon, and the tax needed to be paid. And so it was that Joseph had to go to Bethlehem to be counted, to be registered for the Roman tax. And so it was that he went home, back to his hometown of Bethlehem.
He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. There, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in a cloth and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for him.
A manger. Is that a fit place for the King of Peace to be born? Yes, for that was the secret, the wonder of it, the joy. Emmanuel, God with us, must be born with the people. If he were born in a palace or even in an inn, he would be better than most of us. He'd be better than most, not one of us. To be truly Emmanuel, truly with us, with you and me, he had to be born close to the earth, in a barn with the animals. For it is not all of creation waiting. The donkey, the cow, the sheep, even the chicken, and the dove, the buzzing flies. For those who were at church during Advent, even bats. The hay. In the manger, every aspect of creation was waiting for this moment. Only in a manger could God truly come to us to live with us. With us.
Thank you.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in the manger."
God only speaks to people who come to church? Do you think that God only speaks to certain people with training or special spiritual skills? No way. God speaks in the open field to shepherds, to ordinary people just doing their jobs. God speaks. God's glory shines out there in the dark places. God comes looking for you when you least expect it. The shepherds weren't praying. They weren't waiting for this word from God. They were probably trying to get a bit of sleep. But the message came anyway.
Of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those who he favors."
Angels, we have heard.
left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this things that have happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Stars are brightly shining, it is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul found its worth.
Treasured up all these things and pondered over them.
Meanwhile, the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for what they had heard and seen. It had all happened as they had been told.
Our collection plate is on the little back table there. So if you missed it on the way in and you wanted to leave a donation for the church, you can just put it on that plate on your way out. And let's take a moment as we sing and dedicate our offerings to God in song and in prayer. Turn your little candles on if you haven't already. Good job, Lily. And let's stand and sing. Silence. Holy.
Thank you.